Hey y'all, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. We got a hair tutorial. I'm going to be showing you how I did these super easy braids. These are literally the easiest braids, probably one of the easiest protective styles I've ever done, especially when you're thinking about the concept of time and the wearability. I wore my hair in these braids for like 2.5 weeks, which was perfect because it gave me, you know, the vibe of having box braids or knotless braids. So let's go ahead and get started. I already am coming on camera with my hair blow dried straight, and I moisturize my hair before braiding. So you can definitely use whatever moisturizer you like on your hair. But yeah, definitely having your hair blown out and already moisturized underneath the protective style is super important and the most important part of even wearing your hair in a protective style. But yeah, so I went ahead and sectioned my hair first for these braids. This is by far the longest part of this entire process, is just being able to section your hair because it is really difficult to do by yourself. If you have somebody around who can do it for you, great, but I just did it on my own and knocked it out. As far as what I used to lay my hair down, I used this product from Jam, which it's a partnership collaboration with Magic Fingers. She's an incredible braider, and so I'm using this product to lay my hair down in the braids, and it actually lasted really long. I didn't find any flaking or anything like that with this product, so that was ideal. So I already knocked a few of these out in the back. So as you can see, my hair is already braided. Now, one thing I will say too, because these braids are so thin, you definitely want to make sure when you do your sections that you're creating windows for your braids so that your braids actually lay on different parts. So instead of seeing like bare skin, like bare scalp, you see braid. So yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you exactly how I do each one of these braids. And it's really easy. It's simply a large knotless braid. But to get down to the nitty-gritty of the most complicated part of this outside of getting your knotless braid done at the root is adding in those pieces of hair. And simply you're going to braid it in or feed it in the same way that you would your other hair into the knotless braid. You're just going to use a little bit of the top as part of one piece of your braid, and then the other piece you're gonna kind of hold away. This is important because you wanna just basically secure that top of the piece of hair into your braid, and then leaving obviously the wavy hair out, because that's the whole point, is that it is free flowing. So I'm actually using just like, you know, bag synthetic hair, like weave. So I just cut the actual weft of the bundles off and used this hair. Now, if you are going to plan to do this look, I would highly suggest using the free trust hair. That's like that wavy, wet to wavy hair that people use for this type of style a lot. I found that after I wore my hair in the braids for about a week or so, the hair that I used, the extra hair, the bundle hair, was a bit too soft. So it kind of came out here and there, not too much. It wasn't like a hassle or anything, but I definitely feel like the free trust hair is a better fit for this style. So the next thing that you'll want to make sure to do is to tie a knot at the end of your braid to seal your braid, because we're not braiding all the way down. We're leaving a bit of the hair out at the bottom, which is another reason why using like pre-stretched braiding hair here is the easiest option, because the hair is already like layered in everything so that you don't have to work at pulling the hair to make it look more of like that natural vibe. But this hair, because it's pre-stretched, I simply had to just tie a little knot at the end wherever I wanted the braid to stop, and the ends looked perfect. So I didn't even have to dip steam these braids when I was finished. I literally just tied the knot and was good to go. And I'm just gonna show you a few more clips of me repeating this process over different areas of my head, just to give you some more examples. But yeah, that's pretty much it. This style was super easy, like I said. I loved wearing it in a high bun, in a high ponytail, just down. half up, half down, like all that kind of stuff. It was super cute and really, really good for like a solid couple week protective style. So I hope you enjoyed this video. And until next time, I will see you in my next video. Love y'all. Bye.